This is gonna be the Men in Tights edition.
First time.
Is it your first time wearing tights to the gym?
I feel like
we're gonna be able to see today, or you're gonna be able to see today, if these pants are see-through while he squats.
Nah.
That'll be fun.
Keep in mind, I also have really, really small legs. They're about the size of Lakshmi's, so.
Shut up.
So, that's what makes it extra funny, that I'm wearing them. But honestly, they're comfortable, and they're easy for me to get my knee sleeves on.
That's the biggest thing.
And I don't give a fuck.
For me, like, not that I ever really wear shorts, but even my capri leggings, I never wear them on leg day because I can never get my knee sleeves up. And my knee sleeves aren't even, like, super fitted. Well, they're fitted, but, like, you can get them normal or you can get them, like, extra tight. That's mm-hmm. really bright. So yeah, I always wear pants because they just slide right on.
We're gonna see how it goes. First time. Oh, and check out how I'm matching that. Like, look at this. This is clean because this is not a common color right here.
Why is the lighting so bad?
This is not a common color, but
this is Kunal showing off.
That is clean. Look at that.
All right, so as you guys can see, the gym is pretty empty. It's actually completely empty now. There's a couple working out here, but they're not here anymore. And so we're gonna take the squat rack. I guess you guys won't get to see how people judge me, but we have we're gonna try to keep this pretty raw actually, because they have this big speaker system here, so sometimes when it's playing, like, we can't do any raw clips. I'm gonna show you, like, one of these massive speakers here, but today there's no music playing, so it's quiet, so we're gonna try to keep it raw and kind of just talk to you guys in between clips and stuff. So to start off, we have 4x4 on the squat. I'm doing front squat like you guys know, and Lexi's doing back squat at 77.5%. So Lexi's got 190 on the bar, I have 195, and then we have some deadlifts. So I'm gonna just warm up for squats, and we'll see you guys when working sets.
Like, really hot for cardio, and the weather here doesn't help.
How hot was it today?
It was 100 in my car. So, not really a fan.
Come on. How easy did that feel? I always tell Lakshmi, man, her set's always, like, way too easy for her.
You did underestimate my maxes for every lift, for every lift for this program, just because I've been so out of it for the past, like, 6 months. I haven't been strength training properly. So this is more about getting my confidence back, because, you know, I used to be kind of strong, and now I just don't really feel like it anymore.
But so we put your squat at 245.
Instead of 260 was what I hit at, like, my peak, which was close to a year ago.
Yeah.
We're working on it. We're getting back. Yours seemed easier than mine did.
Yeah, but my knees already started fucking hurting.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
It's funny, because I was telling Lakshmi that my knees
aren't better by any means at all. Like, as you guys can see, that one set, my knees are killing me already for my one knee. But from squatting 3 times a week, since we increased that frequency, I feel like my recovery of my knee has been better. Like, in the sense that when I would squat twice a week, my knees would hurt probably like 5 to 6 days out of the week. And now, my knees will hurt after my leg day, like they usually would. I'll take care of them. And then by the next day, they're typically gone, right? So I'm actually okay for my leg day. So that's really weird. I don't know why, if anybody's ever heard of, like, that increased frequency. of squats to help recovery, but I haven't done anything different in terms of on the recovery side. I've just increased my frequency of squatting, which is what causes the knee pain, but also makes it feel better. So it's weird. All right.
There you go. That was good. For squats, didn't want to film too much because our camera's dying, so we're on to deadlifts and we're doing 245 for 4x4.
Sir, I'm doing 3x4. I'm doing 345 for 3x4, and yeah, I'm going to show you how annoying it is when you lift with the same bar with two completely different weights because they don't have 50 pound plates, they have 45 pound plates, so it's not like you can just slap a 45 on each side of her 245, because then that's 335, and then you got it. You know what I mean?
He's only good at complaining.
You know what I mean? So, you guys didn't see. But, we're gonna do a few more warm-ups. With deadlifts, I think the biggest thing is like, is warming up. Like, people will slap on and do, they'll do a few reps with a certain weight, but I think an important thing is that you should pull the sack out and pull fast from your working set, I mean, from your first warm-up, which is 135, so you actually have a bar on, I mean a plate, and the bar at the right height. But yeah, we're gonna go 225 warm-up. I'm gonna do 315, and then I'm gonna go for my 345, which shouldn't be hard at all. Yeah, enjoy the footage. When I'm going for reps on deadlifts, I use straps. Don't really care. Know my grip's not gonna fail and I can still pull, but it just helps me get in a better position when I'm warming up because I don't do double overhand typically. So this keeps me double overhand and I use straps when I'm going on anything above like 3. Sometimes if I have to do my 4x4, I will do it without straps or something like that, but today I'm using straps. I just said this on my Snapchat. If you're not following me on Snapchat, it's at KPFitness1. I think the biggest mistake that people make is always trying to turn into failure. And obviously, like, you guys that watch, that follow programs and understand programming stuff. But just for the beginners out there, you know, because I used to go to the gym and think I would have to kill it. A good chest workout is when I couldn't do, you know, another rep, another set. And that's just setting yourself up for failure in the long run, guys. Keep as many tools in your toolbox so that as you progress, you have more variables to change. I mean, that's the best advice you give everyone. Do as little as possible to progress so you have more tools in your toolbox. Bodybuilding is a long sport. I always say it. When you're 40, you're not gonna wanna be working out for 3 hours just to get the volume you need in. So, I'll be honest, battery's about to die. Lexi's about to do her second set. We're gonna have to end the video here, guys. So, thank you guys as always for watching. Please hit that subscribe button and share this video. If you like this raw footage, let us know. If you like the voiceovers and whatever, again, let us know. I mean, we make these videos for you guys, nothing else. So, we'd like to take your feedback and then give you guys that last set. Or, I mean, last clip. That looks like speed work, doesn't it?